Well, as frontline workers in the Bay Area get their first dose of the Pfizer vaccine this week, we are learning about possible side effects and the people more likely to experience them. From coast to coast, frontline staff and nursing home residents are rolling up their sleeves.
We hope the overwhelming percentage of the population will accept the vaccine.
California may have two different vaccines by the end of the week. According to the FDA, there may be temporary side effects, including fatigue, headache, and muscle pain.
It means that your body actually is probably mounting a really robust immune response.
The reactions could last a day or so. They're more likely after the second dose and in younger adults.
Which makes sense because oftentimes older adults don't have as a robust an immune response to vaccines.
Stanford's Dr. Grace Lee is a vaccine expert. She advises the CDC as well as the state of California. With the Pfizer vaccine, a new report of severe allergic reaction in Juneau, Alaska. It can occur with any vaccine, and in fact occurs more frequently with other medicines like penicillin.
And it can happen out of the blue in people who've never had it before.
The FDA is also tracking reports of Bell's palsy, a condition that causes a temporary weakness or paralysis of the muscles in the face.
It really freaks people out, understandably, because they wake up in the morning and they can't move one side of their face and they're drooling and they're eyes may be slumped.
The exact cause is unknown, but it can occur after a viral infection, including COVID.
So we don't know what causes Bell's palsy, but we think it's inflammation of the nerve.
Well, as for those already vaccinated here in the Bay Area, San Francisco's COVID command told us so far none of the five individuals vaccinated yesterday reported any side effects at all. The same goes for the 27 people vaccinated in Contra Costa County.